A Moro youth group in central Mindanao has been campaigning to counter attempts carried out through social media recruiting to join extremist groups. The Union of Muslim Youth Organizations, or UMYU, put away young Muslims from the misguided ideology being espoused by the Islamic State of Iraq and Syria, or ISIS, a terror group that has reportedly entered the country with religion as their cover. UMYU says, the evidence to this is the existence of Mauti Group, Khalifa Islamia Movement, Bangsa Moro Islamic Freedom Fighters, and Abu Sayyaf, which all have aligned with ISIS. UMYU says they aim to deepen the understanding of Islam among the youth to cultivate a moderate interpretation of the faith.
Ang social media is very effective and influential na maka-mold ng mind ng tao, especially sa mga youth. So, yung advocacy on the, radicalism ng other groups is through social media is napakilaki pong ang impact sa amin. No? So, malaki pong epekto nun. So, that's why as much as we can, na if not eradicate, at least mamitigate man lang yung radical ideology is ginagawan po namin ng paraan. And usually, yung mga na-involve sa mga ganyan is yung bago nag-i-implement ng correct teaching ng Islam. So, dahil sa eagerness nila na mag-seek and mag-practice ng teaching ng Islam, so, hindi na nila kinukonsulta yung mga elders. So, they are umaasa na lang sila sa research nila, which is yun yung majority na reason bakit marami sa kabataan ngayon yung nai-involve sa radical activities.
On December 22 last year, former police officer assigned in Antipolo Rizal Province, Jesse Vincent Ginto Original, or better known as Abu Aisha, a Muslim convert, was arrested in Barira, Maguindanao, together with four others, in joint police and army operations. He claims to have trained hundreds of fighters of the Mauti group and admitted his involvement in Davao bombing in September last year. He was captured in an attempt to escape the intense military offensive against them in Butig, Lanao del Sur.
Gaano kadami yung na-train mo doon?
100.
Ng mga bata? Halos ba kabataan doon?
Marami.
Nasa jihad. Yun po yung ano eh. Yung utos sa amin sa Quran. Yun ang paniniwala namin.
National Youth Commission Chairperson singer-actress Isa Segura visits Cotabato City and Maguindanao in town hall meeting with Moro youth last December. Issues of peace, security, education, and youth radicalism were raised. Segura considers the influence of violent extremism one of the toughest challenges confronting the youth in Mindanao. Working now with UNICEF and Bangsa Moro Youth Affairs, she is proposing a Mindanao Youth Camp for better understanding between the Moro youth and Manila-based youth organizations.
Isa to sa mga issues talaga. And ang hirap kasi talagang minsan out of poverty or minsan talagang through, of course, through the through religion. At talagang napakaraming factors eh. And right now, if you're gonna ask me kung anong gagawin namin, I don't know yet. But we will definitely work with whoever we can work with. I mean, with NGOs, international NGOs. First, and hopefully talaga mas ma, with the local government. So talagang they have programs actually to stop this cycle. And talagang siguro ang laki ng piniplay na role ng edukasyon talaga eh. Kasi without education, ang iisipin ng mga tao, isipin ng mga kabataan that I have no other option. But that's not true. There are many options. So isa sa mga naisip namin din is magkaroon kami ng parang Mindanao Youth Peace Camp. Hindi lang pala ang pagiging child soldier ang way to go. Hindi lang pala through violence ko makakamit yung mga pangarap ko. So we have to give them options. And we have to arm them with not arms, but with education and skills.
For 8-year-old Danza Sabpa, ugto ka nalipaw mama sa Panang Maguindanao, who dreams of becoming a teacher, surges for a stop to violence. She becomes emotional as she narrated to Segera how she and her family were deeply affected by the mama sa Panang encounter and the need to evacuate every time a clash occurred nearby. She blames the cycle of conflict as the reason why her parents didn't achieve their own dreams of finishing studies and to become professionals.
Sana po matulungan yung mga bata mag-aral kasi mga hirap lang yung magulang nila. Yung iba hindi na makapagtapos ng pag-aral kasi wala silang mga pera. Sana po hindi na nilaguluhin yung mga sundalo para wala nang bakbakan dito. Kasi nakakaawa sila, yung iba hindi nakadadami kasi may bakbakan na. Sana tulungan yung mga bata makatapos ng pag-aaral kasi yun yung pangarap nila.
But for Umyo, the problem of violent extremism is also connected to the success of the peace process. Yaman cites, for instance, that the junking of the Memorandum of Agreement on Ancestral Domain in 2008 provided an opportunity for radical groups to recruit people to their ranks. He adds that the only way to achieve the dreams and aspirations of the Bangsa Moro is for the Moro leaders to unite and the youth to support the peace process.
Itong mga kabataan ay hindi po ma-engage sa mga radical activities, rather sa mga peace initiative po sila dapat mabilong or maging active with the Duterte administration. So, doon po sa mga Bangsa Moro leaders, ang call ko po is sana po is mag-intindihan kung hindi sila magkakaisa about sa pag-resolve po sa mga issue po sa Bangsa Moro area. So, ang number one po na magiging apektado is kami mga kabataan.